These roughnecks will work into the night, trying to get the dog back into the hunt. And Big Dog's not the only one stuck in the mud. At the Longhorn, driller Gerald finally has his full crew. But two-thirds of the way to total depth, the drill bit is stuck.
Today we're not making nothing, so we'll get out there and tackle it and see if we can't get it beat today so we can get back to drilling. Being stuck can last from 30 minutes to 30 days.
Like the Big Dog, the Longhorn is stuck, but the problem is very different. The 64-year-old rig has drilled a crooked hole, and the pipe is caught up in three places. It's a common but potentially disastrous problem.
Very frustrating. When you can't get things done, things are not working for you. It just really frustrates the hell out of you.
Doesn't do you any good to dig a hole, to dig it so damn crooked you can't get pipe in it.
They only have 2 weeks to drill this well. A hole problem puts everything at risk and could mean millions of dollars lost. If they can't get the bit loose, they'll have to cement this well shut and start all over again. Gerald knows there's only one way to get this drill moving, using sheer force.
Kelly driver is about 5,000 pounds of iron welded together. If we pick up and we drop it, just like a hammer, once we get it moving up and down that hole, then we can get somewhere. This ain't gonna be no easy task.
But it's a dangerous strategy. The slightest problem can lead to disaster. It takes years of experience to handle this kind of power. So Gerald decides to attach it himself.
Right there. Above that floor, it's dangerous. There's no way to get any leverage. It ain't no picnic up there, that's for damn sure.
Coming down a little bit.
Slamming the Kelly driver puts everyone in danger. It's like dropping a pickup truck onto the rig floor. Gerald makes sure his guys are out of the way before the 2.5 tons of steel comes crashing down.
You pick it up and you drop it. It's gonna make a lot of noise. And you will probably feel it standing here on the ground.
Gerald knows with that much force, the smallest thing can be a real danger.
Last time we were doing this, we had a lot of cottonseed hulls in our mud and on that flat surface where that thing lands. When I got home that evening, a lady friend of mine had to take a pair of tweezers and pick that cottonseed out of my skin. Where that hammer hit it, and it shot out and embedded into my face.
Being stuck. The Viking crew is like a family. Steve gives Junior the lift he needs to finish the job.
Kicking ass, buddy.
There's that bit sub. Here it comes.
The nearly 2 mile trip is finally over, and the bit is out of the ground.
Right there, driller.
Old pro Wayne thought the bit could survive to the bottom of the hole. But the Viking's computer called for a change. New technology got this one right.
We done good pulling it like we did today. You can see on this bit right here, the diamond cutters were starting to wear all the way in the middle right here. Once you get a little chip on them and you keep drilling, then you start cutting into the diamonds on them. These bits right here, they'll cut a lot faster hole than the conventional bit. Hell, they'll double your penetration.